And over here, there used to be a lagoon, and then it had black sand beach.
The Ka'avaloas have had more than their share of experiences with lava, affected by three separate eruptions over a span of more than 50 years, from Kapoho to Kalapana, and most recently, Pahoa. Months before the lava even started heading toward Pahoa, Pi'ilani's grandmother warned them it was coming.
And so I told her, I said, Mom, no, the lava still stay up Mauka, you know, and no more lava coming this way. She says, no, the lava coming.
Turns out she was right. The lava began erupting from a new vent on Pu'u O'o crater on June 27th of 2014.
And she passed away in April, and she didn't get to see the lava flow or see any of it, but she saw it in a dream. She said, no worry. Yeah, that's all she taught us. No worry, pray, just be prepared.
Although the looming danger often crawls at a snail's pace, preparation is everything. And nobody understands that more than Daryl Oliveira.
What we say and do has a secondary impact, a socioeconomic impact. Right from the get-go, by declaring an emergency, you know, there became a moratorium on insurance policies. So there was an immediate reaction to the event that resulted in some impact on the community.
Armed with information from scientists at Hawaiian Volcano Observatory, daily observations from the air and on the ground, as well as input from police, fire, and other county agencies, Oliveira's words ignite change, from the construction of new roads, to the protection of utilities, to the evacuation of students from area schools. But not all follow his advice. Some rely on a higher source.
During that time, while most people are moving out and the schools are relocating, we decided to turn it around and make it an educational moment and give hope to it and bless it and feel good about it, you know. Send our aloha to Pele.
The charter school Steve runs is directly in the path of Pele.
And, you know, there's power in collective positive thinking. And we just put all our collective positive energy towards it. And it stalled miraculously. You might say coincidental, I think not.
And this isn't the first time he's faced Pele. He lost his home in Kalapana.
I'm really proud of our whole school staff and parents and community. Instead of despair, we had hope. Instead of fear, we had respect.
So we walk on this barefoot because it's so young and delicate. This is like a young baby. This is Pele, the youngest I've ever seen her and been able to put my feet on her. Hele ho'i ke ala mauka o ka'u.
Hele ho'i ke ala kai o puna. For his students, Pele provides a lesson plan like none other.
When we was on it, then I felt like happy that we got to go on it and experience how it feels to be on it.
Is there any anger for what she has done or no?
No anger.
Why?
She just helps the land.
When you look out and you look out at all of this, what do you see when you look at this?
New land. New beginning. A new start. Kuka'i'ia kahaloala
pavehi mai na lehua. Things like this is an actual tangible reminder that, hey, live every moment. Enjoy what you see, because tomorrow it might be this landscape. So it's a reminder to us.
A reminder of just how small and powerless we really are when confronted by this unbelievable force of nature.
But as powerful as Pele is, and as much as she takes, she also has another side, one that is both caring and sparing.
The lava has made the road leading to Pahoa Japanese Cemetery impassable by car, a place Aiko Sato used to visit every couple of weeks to put flowers on her grandparents' gravesite.
I was prepared for the entire cemetery to be lost, but when I
actually heard that the cement lava had covered, I cried. Yeah, because I think, wow, grandma and grandpa and all the immigrants buried here are gone forever.
Most of the cemetery is now under a blanket of lava. The lava uprooting some headstones and burying others. But it didn't claim everything.
I couldn't believe that a Sato grave was spared.
It's as if the lava purposely went around. So why? Why was this saved?
My sister tells me because I took the time to come to the grave before it was covered. She told me, you went to visit grandma and grandpa, so it'll be spared. Yeah, because I wanted to ensure that there will be fresh flowers if and when the lava came through.
For grandma, grandpa, and Pele.
It seems unreal, like still in a dream. Yeah, but we were really fortunate that the grave is still here.
Aiko has lived in Pahoa for most of her life. This is the house where she grew up and still lives. And while the lava no longer appears to be threatening the cemetery, it's still threatening her home.
In the back of her mind's always, how long? You know, is it going to be this way? How long until I get back to normal?
She's already put 90% of her belongings in storage and chooses to stay put and wait.
It's no matter what, it's my home. I want to remain at home as long as possible. But I don't, if lava should take my place, I don't want to see it burning, the home burning. I want to be away at that time.
She's hopeful Pele will spare her home, just like she spared her grandparents' gravesite. Coming up on Kilauea, Facing the Fire, we look to the future